What's up, my YouTubing YouTube friends? Today is a very special day because we have hit 100,000 followers. 100,000 and 100,000. What the fuck am I trying to say? Day because we have hit 100,000 YouTube subscribers on YouTube. Thank you guys for that. I really appreciate it. I feel like we did that relatively quickly. So to reward you guys for that, we're going to do a home studio tour. So hope you enjoy. Check it out. Let's start with the desk. We've got the output desk in gray. It took a long time to get here, but it's finally here and it looks really nice and I'm really happy with it. It's got three rack space units. I'm hardly using any of them. I have an AxeFX 2 that I use sometimes, occasionally, sometimes I don't. And then I've also got Furman power conditioner. It's just a normal one. And that's pretty much all I'm using for that. I've got the Apogee Duet for an interface, which works pretty nicely. And sometimes I use an iPad to make things. Cool stuff there. For monitors, I'm using the Dynaudio LYD-8s. They sound really nice. I also have this Sony 47-inch TV screen for my actual monitor. And then under the desk, we've got the Yamaha subwoofer. It's the same one for the HS8. And, you know, a dog bed and a footstool for playing guitar. The desk also has a keyboard tray, which is really nice and convenient because I used to have to put the thing on the desk. I'm using the S61 Complete Control, which is also really nice and convenient for my writing style. My MacBook is a 2018 MacBook Pro with a touch bar. It's an i9, 32 gigs of RAM, and a 2 terabyte hard drive. We've got this cool blooper thing sent to me by the Chase Bliss guys, so thank you for that. And yeah, that's the desk. It's really nice and really cool. The chair is from IKEA, and it's pretty cool looking. It's nice and clean. To the right of the desk, we've got my signature THBB10. This is the original one. It is pretty dope. As you can see, on each side of the desk, we've got two light cabinets. In each drawer, we have marijuana products and marijuana accessories. Shout out Caliva Marijuana Company for giving me lots of marijuana. We've got what looks like Nug, head, neck, and shoulder tension. Got these bad boys. We got some candy. This is actual candies. We got pens, cartridges, flour in a bag. More goodies here. You know, whatever the fuck this is. Shout out Khalifa. Thank you very much for keeping the creativity going. Behind the desk, there's quite a lot of leaves and branches and just general greenery. On this side, we've got a cute little Gucci backpack. And then these are all my backpacks. This one is really convenient for sessions. It's really nice, and I just throw my laptop in there and all my cords and stuff and head to a session. This one is for light traveling, and then this one is for long tours. Here we have a picture of me and the gang, brought to you by Clay Gober. Shout out Travis Schutz, shout out Clay Scott and Clay. Miss those boys, they're all in Texas. I live in LA, so it's nice to have them here in the studio with me even when I'm alone. Moving over here, we have the whiteboard that I work on a lot. This is our Polyphia 100,000 subscriber plaque. When I get the plaque for this video, I guess we'll put that one here, and I guess I'll start a new YouTube channel and we'll get another 100,000 on that one. We'll just start collecting plaques in that area. So this is my collection of guitars, just a portion of them. But these are the main ones that I use. This first one is one of the original six AZ guitars that ever existed. I had the LA Custom Shop refinish it to clitoris pink. That is trademarked. It's nice because we've got the white on white on white on white. White strap knobs, white pickups, white inlays, white logo. Here, we've got a stock AZ Prestige from Japan. It plays really nice. And yeah, It's really pretty. Moving on. Here we have, this was one of the first guitars I ever got from Ibanez, and this was the first guitar that I ever got customized at the LA Custom Shop. As you can see, gold on gold, white on gold, and then more gold up here. The bar on this one is black though, and so is some of the hardware, so it's just a beautiful guitar. I don't really play it too much, it's kind of just here for looks and sentimental value. Moving on, this is my Talman. It's just a prestige Talman. There's nothing really too special about it other than it kicks ass and sounds really awesome. I used to use this guitar a lot, but then I got the Signature, which I based the pickup sound off of this particular guitar. Here we have a stock THBB10 and yeah, it's really nice. Say hi to your brother.
Woo!
Okay, moving on. This guitar is really special. This is a nylon stringed Ibanez with a classical headstock. I found this guitar somewhere in Europe. I think it was Cologne, Germany, in just like a random music shop. And I was like, oh my god, this thing is so sick. So I just bought it and took it back to America with me. Next up, we've got my Ibanez 8 string, gold hardware, and you know, white on gold, more gold. As you can tell, I like gold a lot. It's really nice. And last but not least, we have this bass. I told Ibanez that we were doing writing sessions and I need a bass, and they sent this one. I have no idea what it is. It's got gold hardware, so I like it a lot. And Clay says it's a nice bass, so works for me. It's really long. Check this angle out. Ooh, look at that. Look how long that bitch is. What the fuck? Got a printer and some HS8s that I think I'm going to move into Studio B, but I haven't done yet, so here they are. We have a really nice, big, comfortable couch. This is probably my favorite part of the room, this couch. I don't really have anything on the walls because we're gonna move and I just don't feel like hanging anything up. But yeah, this couch is just fantastic. Now over here, we've got this cool skeleton-looking guy up here. He's just there for decoration. We've got the Japanese edition of New Levels, New Devils. I want to say this is pretty rare. This mask, I think, is like steampunk or something. Me and Y2K went to an antique store one time and picked these up because we figured, you know, rappers like to pose with cool things in the studio, and this would be a cool thing that rappers could pose with in the studio. So we each got a steampunk mask for our studios. We got some fan art back here. Dunlop Superpus. Superpus? We got a Dunlop Superpus. Supa? Dunlop Superpus. An Ibanez something or other, and a Twin Note something or other. Gucci bag. Kawaii picture of us in Japan. More fan art down here. And that's pretty much Studio A. Moving on to Studio B. This is Studio B. It's kind of like a gaming studio. This is where I Twitch stream and play games, and when we have sessions, there's, you know, other people can come in here and work. Alexa, turn Studio B lights white.
Okay.
So, as you can see, we have, you know, more foliage behind the desk here. We've got like a Elgato something light. We've got this plant up here that Gigi really, really likes. More foliage kind of under the desk. We've got a Focusrite interface and a Blue Yeti mic, just basic things for streaming. We've got the JBL 8s over here, which I'm gonna replace with those HS8s in the other studio. Yeah, you know, a TV with PS4 and a Switch and lots of games. We've got some Berserk manga down here. Berserk's my favorite. We've got the Clone Hero controller for when I play Polyphia songs on Clone Hero. Here we've got kind of the dark side of my little weeb figurines. We've got Guts over here and whatever the fuck this is that I got from Japan. It's really tight. Quite disturbing. This was a necklace. You wear that as a necklace. Here we've got a really cool print by Sloppy Jerkery on Instagram. Shout out that dude. He makes really dope shit. Shout out my girlfriend for getting me really dope shit. She also got me these really cool figurines over here. More weeb shit. We got No Face. We've got the Baylet. Crimson Baylet. We've got the anime girls and some samurai sword shit. So that's Studio B. A nice matching rug to Studio A. Walking in here, Studio A. So yeah, that about concludes our studio tour. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Make sure to like and subscribe and comment and all that good stuff. And I guess we'll do another one when I move and hit 200K. And I'm sure the studio will be even sicker then. So anyways, thanks guys.